This video explains the effects of variation on the queue and waiting time of a process. We take the last bit of Kingman's equation and focus on the direct effect of variation on the queue. We expect that you already have seen the introduction video about Kingman's equation and the video explaining the effect of utilization. So, let's look at what we already know. This is Kingman's equation. And this states the parts that can make a mathematical calculation that makes an approximation of the expected mean waiting time in a queue. We already discussed the effects of utilization of the process, and we saw that variation has a large effect in combination with a high utilization. We also saw what the effects are if you add parallel servers or parallel processes. This provided the indirect effects of variation through the utilization. In this video, we state the direct effects of variation on the waiting time. We use the same basics, but now we focus on the direct effect of variation in arrival times and variation in job times on the waiting time. Let's go back to the effects of variation. We saw that the queue appears if the time between the arrivals of different products in the input varies. And the more variation, the larger the queue and longer the waiting times. The same effect can be seen if the time it takes to process a job varies. You can imagine that in a normal process, usually both the arrival time of the input and the processing times varies. This variation in the arrivals can be caused by a lot of reasons. Some are stated here. And of course, the variation in job time can be caused by a lot of different situations too. What you can see is the variation of these two are not related. There is usually not one common cause. Now we want to see the total effect of these two variations on the waiting time. What we really want to know is how large is the spread of the real times in relation to the mean or average time. If we measure a number of occasions and we put these in a graph, we can see what this spread is. We put on the x-axis the time it takes and on the y-axis the number of occasions. By the way, these can be measurements of the arrival times and measurements of the job times. The purple line in the middle of the graph represents the mean time. If the times are usually near or spot on the average time, the effect on the waiting times are relatively small. This is represented by the blue line. But if the measurements, as presented in the orange line, show that these times are almost never the mean time or even near the mean time, you know the waiting time will be large. In statistics, there is a measure for this spread. This is the coefficient of variation. We assume that you know about statistics and will not explain this coefficient further. In Kingman's equation, we use CV for the arrivals and CV for the job. The effect can be described best by the sum of the square of the CV of arrival and the square of the CV of the job time divided by 2. So, let's fill this in the formula we have. This is the job time, multiplied by the effect of occupation and multiplied by the effect of variation. Don't forget that the symbols used can differ in literature, software programs, and so on.